I il Signore sia con voi. My warm welcome to Natalie and Phil. Also in the name of the community, Christian Community welcomes you, and it's our great honor to share with you this political first moments of your life together. It's a official life together. And so, celebrate with joy, and I wish you that celebrate your love every day. So, before we enter into the celebration, we invite the two mothers to light the unity candle. Philip and Natalie, two different persons coming from different ways, and so we ask the mothers to underline this dimension as they are coming from two different ways.
Slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. How good is the Lord to all. All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessing. The eyes of all creatures look to you, and you give them their food in due time. How good is the Lord to all. The Lord is just in all his ways, and loving in all his deeds. He is close to all who call him, who call on him from their hearts. How good is the Lord to all.
Now we ask Lindsay to read for us the second reading. We are celebrating love. And thanks to Natalie and Phil that we would say especially at this moment. And is so that to celebrate God. And so we are in the middle of a great mystery revealed by this precious moment for Natalie, Philip, and everyone of us around them. It is kind of a dark, more precious almost than the Eucharist. And God is revealing Himself in this simple moment action, exchanging love is not not so simple. Exchanging marriage vows, a consent between two persons that love each other very much, and is exchanging a consent for life. So we have a great moment that we are with you. Not just to ask a blessing, but as I said, many gifts. As we are already happy that you choose the greatest one, like St. Paul said, love, that is the source of every other gift. So he said, be proud of your choice. And from there, we expect marvelous things, and God said, the more simple instrument I can use, I will make things that you don't imagine, do not imagine. So we trust also on that and see what something else that will come out of your relationship and sharing with you the future moments of your life. For the first time, you are building your house on your own. Also, we know that we have to manage our own personality, our fragile human being. So, I think that after the main councils that proposal that your parents will give you and already gave you, I think we doubt from St. Paul passions as you will be passionate with each other. You still grow and you will grow more in your love, your way of relation. And so you will still welcome each other, one another, as the first as today, with happiness and waiting to see something else, something always positive, something merits. One could express to the other. And so, to teach this love. And the other things I would say would be this, maybe, as you like, and your gentleness and your creativity in a way that your future is a nice contest in which each of you try to be first in to love the other. And so see the best and keep the best for each other. What we want is to see you with the same happiness in the future days is what also we together wishes to you. We wish this to you, and so may God bless you, and come back as here we celebrate God, and we have more to share with the community of faith, this source of gift, love, and life. And so I think it will be precious for you. Possiamo dire due parole in italiano? Perché innanzitutto siamo onorati che loro ci hanno invitato qui a condividere questi tre più momenti della loro vita insieme, Natalie e Phil. Vogliamo che siano i più belli e quindi siamo contenti di
avevo scelto con l'amore, scelto Dio, scelto di vedere benedetta la loro unione all'altare del Signore, e abbiamo chiesto di tornare qui alla sorgente, a Dio, alla sorgente dell'amore, con la comunità, a condividere il bene, il male, il futuro, e abbiamo chiesto soprattutto di essere pazienti l'uno con l'altro, perché l'amore, come la persona cresce, si adatta, si inventa, è creativa, e dovranno darsi il benvenuto con la stessa contentezza e felicità sempre, anche quando sarà meno piacevole o più piacevole o differente il loro modo di esprimersi e di donarsi reciproco. E quindi li invitiamo ad essere pazienti l'uno con l'altro e lasciare che ciascuno cresca e si esprima a modo suo, e senz'altro vorranno fare del loro meglio, come ho detto, potrebbe essere il futuro, il loro futuro, una piccola gara di tutti e due a chi si ama prima, e probabilmente viene fuori qualcosa di eccezionale. Il Signore possa venire.
husband and wife. Holy Father, you created mankind in your own image and made man and woman to be joined as husband and wife in union of body and heart, and so fulfill their mission in this world. Father, to reveal the plan of your love, you made that union of husband and wife an image of the covenant between you and your people. In the fulfillment of this sacrament, marriage of Christian man and woman is a sign of the marriage between Christ and the Church. Father, stretch out your hands and bless Natalie and Philip. Lord, grant that as they begin to live this sacrament, they may share with each other the gift of your love and become one in heart and mind as witnesses to your presence in that marriage. Help them to create a home together and give them children to be formed by the gospel and for a place in your family. Give your blessing to Natalie, your daughter, so that she may be a good wife and mother, caring for the home, faithful in love for her husband, generous and kind. Give your blessing to Philip, your son, so that he may be a faithful husband and a good father. Father, grant that as they come together to your table on earth, so they may be one day have the joy of sharing your feast in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. So now, as Chanas, let us pray as the Lord talk to us, saying, Our Father, thy kingdom come, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And the first, our precious gift that we can also graciously touch is peace with God and with our relatives and friends and community. So let us share a sign of peace. They say amen after each of my prayer. God the eternal Father, keep you in love with each other, so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and be always in your home. May your children and your friends bless you, console you, and command you in peace with you. May you always bear witness to the love of God in this world, so that the afflicted and the needy will find in you generous friends and welcome you into the joys of heaven. And may the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thomas, Natalie, and Phil, the maid of honor, Glenn and Jenny, come up for the signature of the license. You may be seated.
Thank you.
Father, our blessed Mother Mary, at this powerful and moment of hunger, so that she will bring us help to the blessed Mother.
Thank you. standing
come on
next
down.
To Glenn.
Wait, wait, buddy. Come on right down. Come on down, guys.
It was standing right next to Glenn, huh?
Yes, you're over here.
Whoa.
Oh, that's the real. I'm lucky you're here to tell us.
I can't see the parents. Just like that, that's good.
Smile,
first wedding. Okay, that's good. One more, hang on a minute. Hold that right there, that's good. One more too, that's it.
Yeah.
We're on Meryl's shoulders.
Yeah. There we go, just like that. Hold right there, everybody, that's good. Right here. Beautiful.
Josie, you want to go take a picture of the horses?
People, we got work to do.
This is heavy duty greeting.
Oh, you can give the napkin. You can give the napkin. Plug in the door.
The wedding where nobody came.
Hi. 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 Hi
Oh, so.
I've met you before.
You look strange in front of me.
Okay, are we sure we don't have any more guests?
I don't know, we'll wait for everyone to sit down and we'll see if there's any interesting.
All right. more stragglers.
Michael, here you see it. Ice cream.
Ice cream.
Okay, look at me and say ice cream. 1, 2, 3, ice cream.
Ice cream.
Good night. Beautiful. Good boy. What a kid. Drop your flower just a touch. Yeah, beautiful. Just like that. If you hold it right there, that's good. Two shots like this. If you hold it right there like that, that's good. Beautiful. That's perfect. One more like that, okay? Beautiful, just like that. Dad, watch that hand coming through there. Looks like she got a growth. Jane, the hand, flower's on the other side. Now that would cover up the hand now, I suppose. Like that, everybody. Hold it right there. That's good. Two or three shots like this, guys. Two shots. Like that. Hold it right there. Don't blink. It's good. Hold that. It's nice. It's good enough. Like that, everybody. Hold it right there. That's good. Natalie, body towards me a bit more. Yeah, I like that. That's good. Beautiful, guys. Just like that. Hold it right there. Don't blink. It's good. Hold it. Nice. Mom, put your
bride, Mr. and Mrs. John Graniero. Susan Ozels, the mother of the groom, escorted by Harold Judas. We have the bridal party, first Ivan Bowman and Nicole Milosz. Susalu, Donna Iruso. Kevin Devitt and Tina Ozels.
Interesting choice.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise and join me in welcoming the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Natalie and Phil Graniero.
it going?
So, man, did you count the loot?
It's a good score. That envelope's right up there.
Woohoo!
Checking
that. A little money monitor.
We don't have the same last name.
Yeah.
But she's still my sister. We have the same face in here.
That would take some serious work.
Here?
Kevy, all on his own.
I'm pretty sure it wasn't just something I said.
Nobody else. Keep packing away, Kev. Come on, man. You got four chicken cordon bleus here.
Kev's recovering. Kev's just having one plate extra today.
All right.
One main plate and two pasta plates.
Oh, no. More presents?
Pizzies.
More bloody presents.
No.
Thank God. Hope you didn't buy these, buddy.
Gary looks good.
Hello, he's not.
Okay. Hi, Ivan.
Hi, bye.
Now, Ivan, you didn't finish your plate.
I'm working on it.
All right, buddy. I did not see this cup before.
Or the ring.
Or the ring.
Ooh.
Wait a sec. And
got a shot of that?
Wow.
Nice.
Cool.
Yeah. And then the cup.
So, man.
Engraving and all, eh?
Yeah. Oh.
This is the after-game interview.
So, wedding went well, I think?
Yes, went very well.
I see. How did you find it in the fourth quarter there?
Well, you know, for a little while there...
Had a couple of Ave Marias in there.
I never got to finish my joke.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm out of here. I'm just kind of like sitting in a hole.
Oh, I know. Fred.
No. Get him sitting in a hole.
She tries.
She does. You have to grind. So do I have a big lipstick mark on my face?
No, do I? Do I still have
No.
And there you go. So, a couple of Ave Marias in the fourth quarter there, but otherwise,
yeah,
the game plan was pretty
smooth through there, yeah.
Pretty straightforward.
We didn't have too many injuries or balling happening, you know, so quite under.
Do you feel the team worked well?
It was pretty close in the kickoff there. We almost lost some yardage due to, crying on the field, but it worked out. The team came through.
Excellent. Yeah,
so,
let's see. What other things are you going to need to see in 20 years? Oh, yeah.
The ear. Gotta have the ear.
The goddamn earring.
Oh, for sure. And the nose.
Hey.
Ooh, slimy's on the windscreen there.
We pause. And this is the perspective from the bridal party. Wow. We have all the perspectives of this place.
Yeah, it's all there.
Pretty much. So, where are you going for your honeymoon, buddy?
Well, we're heading into Toronto to go to the Royal York Hotel for a few nights.
Oh, I see.
Yes, we're going to do Toronto with a little style. We're going to take in the Phantom, and we're going to dine at the top of Toronto restaurant with award-winning waitresses and chefs at that place. And we may take in the Ontario Art Gallery just for a cultural event.
I see.
A little bit of shopping in the Eaton Centre.
Taking advantage of this little gift, probably.
As little as possible. Yes. We'll see what happens, don't you know? Depends how good the bargains are.
I see.
Yeah.
Interesting. What's going to be the major purchase of this, do you think?
Oh, we're doing Christmas shopping, basically. When we're dining.
I see.
As far as this goes here, we'll have to be looking at getting a car shortly, so this will help nicely in getting that all worked out and get a bit of that established. While Matt's commuting while she's working, bringing in the paycheck, and I'm doing the student thing.
And slacking off.
Well, for sure, yeah. So she'll... Whoa!
There it is. So, hi. How you doing, buddy?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Had a good feed?
Yeah.
Is it?
Good feed. That magic moment of bustling has just occurred.
It must get lonely up there.
It does. No one has an appetite like me.
Oh, it's just Kevy. We just let him eat away.
Even the waitress is still sorry for me because I don't have friends. Don't you feel guilty?
No.
I'm not sitting on that end.
Yeah, that's because you have no soul, Barry.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I guess I'm gonna have to now. Even though she's 23, she's still my baby sister. And loving her and worrying about her will always be in my job description. So Phil, this is where you come in. I'm putting my sister in your hands. So it's your responsibility to take care of her and make sure there's a smile on her face every day. Because if there's not...
Guess who comes in?
To take care of things. All those big old cousins over there. I'm sure you'll do just fine. From what I can see, my sister couldn't have made a better choice. I'm honored to have you in our family and as a brother-in-law, and I'm sure Amaranth feels the same way. Apart from the spoon fights and the kickboxing matches in the kitchen, we still love you very much. I just want to wish you both happiness and joy forever.
Where's the cake?
Where's the cake? The cake by tonight.
The ears I'm going to do for Phil today, as I'm not going to make fun of these ears. Phil has endured these ears his entire life, and I think it's about time we put it to a rest. The other thing I thought about, the very traditional thing to talk about, is the harem of women that were in Phil's life prior to this. But I didn't think that was a good idea. Too bad, I could have gone on for seconds. Phil was always a shy kid, and for those of you who didn't know him in his childhood, take my word for it. He's younger than us, a couple of years longer, so he's always, I guess, the last to go through things. But we were kind of mean, and we pushed him through a lot of things first that we hadn't tried yet. remember one memorable time, we're at an archery tournament, and we convinced Phil to go up and ask a girl for her phone number. And he did it, and he actually got it. And then he walked in front of an open range with a phone number clenched in his hand. Said, "I got it. I wanted to shoot him myself." Unfortunately, his inclination towards sports never improved. He bought his own equipment, practiced at home, and he practiced in his garage, and he missed and shot an arrow through his garage wall into the kitchen where his mother was eating breakfast. If he'd had his hunting tips with him, he'd have pinned her to the fridge. One year we went trap shooting, and the only thing Phil came close to hitting was his left foot. So I have some advice for the Green Arrows. If you take him out for a hunting sport or something like that, don't let him participate in anything where he's a danger to himself or to others. On the good side, with women, his luck finally changed. Phil and I, as younger guys, we talked a lot about women. What they're up to, what's the meaning of women, statistical things. And one day, Phil tried something innovative. Instead of coming and talking to me to figure the problems out, he talked to the girl. It worked. Very proud of Phil, his friend. He's earned a lot of things. The respect of his friends, more academic awards than he even knows he's got. And Natalie's love. We're always very cruel to Phil. That's something to even deserve it. And we used to bug him. He also said he was younger. I don't have cue cards to lose, it's on one sheet. In the short term, I've come to know Natalie. I realize what an accomplishment he's made. I spent some time over the past year as a roommate, friend, and a wedding attendant. I guess some more pleasant than others, eh? And I think this is probably the most important thing you'll ever accomplish in my life. Because even though she had me pegged as a weasel the first time we met, I had a slightly higher opinion. Because not only did Phil talk to Natalie, he stopped talking to us. And when a guy stops talking about women, there's something serious going on. And shortly after that, I knew she was the one. Now, 5 minutes is not exactly, doesn't justify all the things I have to say about these two people. But they asked me to be brief, and I'm going to try to honor my promise. But I'd like to leave you with this note. Alright, technical difficulties. If Phil gives you all the trust, support, and love he's given me as a friend over the past 13 years, and I know he will. Then I know your marriage will be a haven of security, love, success, and most importantly, happiness. And I'd like you all to stand.
Friendships can be a good and a bad thing. bad thing is they're able to get all sorts of good material on you. They have a long list to choose from. But the other good thing about having you know, friends for a very long time is, you know, there's always going to be an opportunity to get them back. As you might have picked up, my friends think I have a tendency to ramble. So I've been limited to this list, and that's going to smack me when my time's up. So I'll try and keep it short. Thanks for everybody that had to drive through that to be here with us. The church ceremony was great. I mean, how could it not be with her coming back to my home? I'd just like to thank Father Adriano for you know, leading us through such a nice celebration. I want to thank Tina and Donna and Lindsay and Marianne for the readings that they did. Did a very good job of that. And I'd like to thank Sue and Barry for doing a great job on the singing. We figured, you know, because everyone applauded, that we'd like to hear from you later too, so. I'd like to thank Mike for starting everything off, the intros and all of that. He's here with from Chicago with Phaedra, so they've come a long way to join us. So I'd like to thank him and my grandfather, Wes Jackson, for saying grace for us to start things off. The past few months also has been absolutely great. Speaking of hard work, Julie and Enyo have had their hands full this weekend. They've both been very busy with their son. He's been a little ill. And then on top of that, he's put up the entire, they've put up, sorry, the entire wedding party. Oh, the ushers are much better. It's okay. Since most of us are from out of town, the wedding party, we've realized the extra difficulties of being here, settling in, getting here, the whole thing. So I'd like per essere qui con noi in questo giorno di felicità. Ci ha fatto molto piacere la sua presenza. Tante grazie. Anyways, I'd like to thank Aunt Anna, Aunt Gina, both our moms, my grandma Jackson and Linda for everything they've done to prepare. There's been some like Glenn and Donna and Eric and Nicole and Kevin that, that gets loud all of a sudden. Natalie and I have known them since we were very young, and they've shown us that time can only really make friendships stronger. And I'd also like to thank Martin and Ivan, because they've shown us that we always have to be ready to open our hearts, or we're gonna miss out on the treasure of some serious friendship. And I'm gonna lose it right now. And I'd also like to thank our sisters, Jamie, Anne-Marie, and Tina, because they've shown us that you can find friendship right at home. There's a few last people that we want to thank. They've been more than friends. They've been providers, they've been teachers, they've been healers. Our parents, you've helped us become the people we are today. You've done more for us than we can possibly list now or thank you for. So we do have a couple of things here to, as a sign of how much you've done for us. So, Over here. This is for my mom, Susan. Okay.
Can everybody hear me still?
Yeah.
Looking a
I'm coming. Yep.
For your bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Philip and Natalie Gennaro. Right now, Philip and Natalie would like to invite the rest of the wedding party to join them on the dance floor. Best man and maid of honor, Glenn Adams and Janie Gennaro. And the bridal party, Ivan Bowman and Nicole Malage. Eric Susilo, Donna Arusha.
Valerie and Josie Castella.
Manchester Kirby, suits and proposals, escorted by Meryl Judas.
Thanks for coming out.
Well, anyway, what was the rest of the song?
Extend the mix version.